Hey all, Ryan the Tone Geek here, and today we're going to learn how to discharge a capacitor the safe way. And that's using this device right here, which is two clips and a wire and a resistor in the middle. And what this is going to do is slowly decrease the voltage out of a capacitor that might be charged still. So we're going to learn how to do that and build one of these fun things so you can have it in your kit. Let's get right to it. So a couple things you're going to need. I picked this up from Harbor Freight yesterday for like $2.50. Make sure you get your 20% off coupon. Just electrical clip assortment. Don't be tempted to grab the pre-made kit because it's not enough voltage. I think that was rated for 300 volts, which brings me to my second requirement. Here's a 600 volt wire. You can pick these up. Mostly any hardware store will have high voltage wire. This is actually from an old transformer, so it's rated 600 volts, and we're going to be good there, and we won't be shocked when we hold the wire. We're going to need a high value. It doesn't need to be anything, you know, you don't have to go out and search a 220k ohm. It could be anything in, you know, above 100k, I would say. One watt and higher preferred. And then some heat shrink, because we're going to cover this whole thing, make it a safe as possible for you. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to open this package and solder some wires to it.
So here's a tip. You can put your wire through the hole like that, and we'll solder on the back side. But now, see how we have a nice coverage here? So when we crimp, it'll wrap the wire real nice and neatly. Like that. Now we have a good surface to solder to. It does require a little extra heat, so turn up your soldering iron. I might actually hold this. Just like that. Now at this point we're gonna slide these over. You might, as a tip, go like that, clamp onto something so it holds it open and slides over easier, and then unclamp. Just like that. There. So now we're going to solder the resistor in the middle of here, but we're going to slide over ahead of time some heat shrink so we can cover the whole thing.
All right, we'll grab our heat shrink that'll fit over. Let's keep it yellow. What do you say? See how it fits over that? All right, so the idea is that we're going to leave as pretty close as short as possible. I'm just going to do some extra because why not? Heat shrink is cheap and I have a bunch of it. So I'll go right about there. And we're going to just slide it over one end here. I mean, I guess I could have done this in reverse, but I think this is the easiest way. Meaning reverse as in take this off, do this the resistor first. But just follow my instructions this way and we'll be all set. So the method I'm going to use to connect this is scientifically proven to be generic. And I'm just going to wrap it around like that, kind of come back. And I'm just trying to make a good mechanical connection at first, or at least the best that I can. So let's see how this does. I think this will be just fine. No cold solder joints. I think we're looking good for that one. Afterwards, I'll clip the lead, you know, the leftover, and we'll move on. So we'll do the final side. I'm gonna wrap this around and then sort of fold back this side, give it a little crimp with my fingers, nothing crazy. Crimp and twist. I'm gonna need a little bit more solder than that. All right. Now we're ready for the heat gun. So first I'm gonna put this over like that. We're going to take the heat gun to it. All right, now that we used heat shrink on here and it had a chance to cool down, I'm going to grab a Sharpie and just write on here, before I forget, how many ohms this was, if I can. So I'm going to very carefully write 220K. That way I know in the future. So now we have our discharging kit, homemade, and you should be proud. And now let's go discharge some capacitors. I don't know if, because what's going to happen is that this capacitance is going to overwhelm without those dropping resistors, or not dropping resistors, but those discharge resistors, it's going to overwhelm the amp. So, or overwhelm the rectifier tube. So I don't recommend that. Let's not blow up anything during this journey. But what I want to do is just walk through the motions with you. So here we have our lead. And by the way, while we're here, let's double check our work. It's going to turn it to ohms. Should be able to clip on both leads. And see 220K. Perfect. Almost on the money. So, while you're in this very dangerous position in your vintage amp, again, I didn't have any issues with this, we're going to very carefully clip both ends of the capacitor and then literally count to 30 and check the voltage with your multimeter again. So at this point, we're taking the positive, negative, and we're discharging it slowly with this resistor. So then after that, go ahead, check your voltage. Of course, everything's always unplugged from the wall, and then do that for every capacitor. Count 30 seconds and so on and so on. So that's the right way to discharge a capacitor. Do not go directly with a short or take your screwdriver and try to short things out. That's not cool. So, go to the next one. And then that's it. Hope you enjoyed that video. Let me know what you think in the comments.